Hello again guys, Ganzu back again here, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a look at character combos with Ganyu, with her releasing soon. I wanted to talk about what characters should you build around her, what compositions, you know, when you're building a team and you want to put her in, who complements her skill set, or, you know, stuff like that. Who works well with her, basically. Now with Ganyu, there's one thing we want to keep in mind, and that's her second charge normal attack. Basically, when you shoot your second charged arrow, it does an AoE. Now if you guys haven't watched my Ganyu character guide, go check that out, link in the description. Without further ado, let's go ahead and look at some combinations you could run her with. Now first off, I think this is going to be one of the greatest options to run, Sucrose. Sucrose is going to be great with Ganyu. She's going to be great for three reasons. One, obviously they're grouping up together, so when you shoot your charge shot, if you fight multiple enemies, she has an easy wave clear. Two, you're going to have that swirl elemental reaction. And three, you're going to have the elemental mastery increase. So just three of those things flat right off the bat. I think that's going to work really, really well with Ganyu. To make it even better, Ganyu's S1 is going to have a little taunt thing, so enemies are already going to naturally go towards the taunting lotus. Then Sucrose is just going to bunch them all together even more. I think Sucrose, just her grouping capabilities period, is just going to be really good. So if you guys don't already have Sucrose, highly recommend you get her now. She is out on the banner. If you guys can get high constellation Sucrose, definitely recommend you should. Next up on our list, we have Venti. Venti is pretty much a no-brainer choice. The Cyclone is just going to be really, really, really good. If you guys don't have Venti, that's okay. Sucrose is always there, but this is just going to make it so easy to group them up together and just spam your normal attack. On top of that, your ultimate's going to be hitting everybody because the crystals are only going to be hitting in one spot and all of them are going to be in one spot, so win-win either way. Again, Sucrose, Venti, just the straight up grouping them together capabilities, that's going to bring so much value, not only to Sucrose, but just to any character in general that uses AoE. Next on the list, we actually have Barbara. Now the reason why I chose Barbara is because if you're running a 4-piece Blizzard Strayer set on Ganyu, putting freeze is going to be super, super easy, as she basically has that on her normal attack and her charge attack. I think the charge attack is going to be really good because it's just going to hit everybody in an area, and then you just pop the Ganyu thing and then boom, easy. I'm thinking about putting the Ganyu Lotus, everyone's going to be running towards the center. You use Barbara, charge attack, and then hit him with the freeze with the Frostflake arrow, and then that increased crit rate. Now the best part is that since she is a support, you do have options open for your sub DPS. So say you want to use somebody else, like say Albedo or whatever, you can use another character while still being able to apply that freeze effect. Next up, we already know we have Mona. Now with Mona, since she already has the taunt effect on her elemental skill, you'll be able to alternate back and forth with Ganyu's and then Mona's, then Ganyu's and Mona's, and you're still going to be applying the wet effect. And with Mona, again, she's also easy to apply the wet since she uses the catalyst. It's just easy freeze, easy freeze. And then of course we have the ultimate, which just literally makes everybody wet. So great option, great option. Catalyst water users, it's just going to be easy for the freeze effect, especially if you're running a 4-piece Blizzard Strayer. Next up on the list, we have Zhengling. Now Zhengling, I wanted to choose a fire character for the melt effect, and actually, Zhengling or Klee would be great options in this case. Both of them serve the same purpose. You drop down your little bear, and then you drop down the little bombs, and then you just use Mona to activate that melt. What's good about these two is you can work around Mona's taunt. You can put the bomb things around the Lotus, and then Zhengling, you can put the little bear around the Lotus as well. You can honestly run Amber for the ultimate ult spam, but I don't know if you guys want to actually build Amber. But if you really want to get that melt damage, these two would be great options, great options. So pretending that Diona is Ganyu, this is something that you could possibly run. This all works around Ganyu. Place down the Lotus, group them up with Sucrose, charged attack with Barbara, hit him with the Frostflake arrow, then you run Zhengling, put down Goba, hit him with another Frostflake arrow, and then just melt consistently over and over again. But the only issue with this team is that you would have either Vaporize or Swirl interfere sometimes. But to be honest, with this setup, you can choose what elemental reactions you want. Let's say you want the crit rate, increased crit rate, put down Barbara, put down the Lotus, and then you just have that increased crit rate on the frozen people. If you wanted the Vaporize, then you'd use Zhengling. If you want to keep it a ranged playstyle, you can even put Amber for the arrows and the Barret Bunny for another taunt. But with the Ganyu, you want to work around clearing multiple enemies in a small area. Grouping them together is what's going to give Ganyu the most value. If you're fighting single target, I mean, you don't really have to worry about it because, you know, you're only fighting one person, but You want to take advantage of the AoE by putting them into an area and then raining down whatever it is. Now there are still other characters that you can run with Ganyu. There's Fischl and there's Jingxu. Of course they're not bad options. As long as you're working around what Ganyu's strengths are, then you should be set. Hopefully this guide helped you on choosing what you want on your team for Ganyu. If you have any questions or suggestions down below, let me know and I'll try my best to answer all of them. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. I know I'm excited for Ganyu. Still can't pull her, but it is what it is. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoy. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.